Good morning, Mary. How are you?
I'm fine, Lisa. How are you today?
I'm doing super. Today we have with us Mary Buchanan. And Mary, I believe you live in Richmond, Virginia. Is that correct?
I do.
And you have been a quilt or fiber artist for how long now?
I was a trained printmaker in school and began working in quilts around 1996, but I entered quilting traditionally and didn't begin making my own fiber or my own imagery until closer to 2000.
Now, that's really interesting coming from a print background. Now, are the quilts that you're making right now, like, do you hand dye all of your own fabrics and then print on them? What's kind of your genre, so to speak?
I work with thickened MX chemical dyes and I cut a lot of stencils. So very basic printing techniques.
Now, I'm curious with your stencils, are you using, some people use like file folders. What types of things are you using to cut your stencils out
An
of?
X-Acto knife and frosted Mylar.
Okay.
And I also will over dye or discharge areas. And I have recently enjoyed printing using my inkjet printer, which is very accessible to me at home.
And you're
And
putting fabric, like fabric sheets, through the printer.
I'm stabilizing silk onto freezer paper after having treated it with bubble jet set, and then basically collaging onto the top of the scanner, and then printing that image and layering it on top of multiple images to get depth of field and transparency.
Well, that's really interesting because basically what you're talking about is photo montage. So you're basically creating a photo montage in your scanner, scanning the image and then printing it, correct?
Exactly. And then I'll take those pieces and cut them and sew them in collage. It is very similar to collage. I'm working on a whole cloth background and have not been piecing work as much as I used to. So it's multiple layers of fine fabric so that I can needle them afterwards that
Okay, terrific.
are collaged on. I was using a fusible adhesive, but have decided that I don't think that it allows for the true nature of the fiber to be explored. So
Okay,
I and
well,
I'm also, oh, sorry.
No, I can appreciate that, because there are times when fusing is wonderful, depending on what you're composing,
It
and there
is
are
one.
other times where it's like, for example, I like to do trapunto work behind a lot of my stuff and, make it a 3D effect. So it really all depends on what you're doing. Do you have a specific subject matter that you like to explore or are currently exploring?
For the last year and a half, I've been working with issues related to Alzheimer's or various memory impairments, Wernicke-Korsakoff, Parkinson's disease, age-related dementia, Alzheimer's and related dementias. Yes.
And how did you come upon this deciding to work on this particular series of this subject?
I had the opportunity to spend 3 years working with senior adults in a memory support environment as a visiting artist. So I worked a lot with the individuals there and we had collaborations of sorts.
That's really interesting. Now, let me ask you a question. Did you have a situation where was working with them with the art kind of trying to help them in terms of their memory functions, or was it basically more of a feel-good healing thing for you to be there? Was there a specific goal in mind?
I'm not an art therapist, so my position there wasn't to provide therapy, but certainly the experience was therapeutic and a tremendous relief of anxiety. A lot of people suffer from anxiety. Where do I go? What am I supposed to do? And when I can engage somebody with memory impairment in continuity of experience for 45 minutes, it offers a freedom from some of the limitations they're experiencing physically and mentally.
I think that also happens with those of us who aren't quite up there yet with them.
Absolutely.
We need that ability to, you know, heal ourselves through our art and experience it. Most artists I've found, that's part of the reason they do it as well. It's a safe refuge, so to speak.
The repetition of stitching is really mind freeing for me. So when I get to the point where I can focus on hand embroidery, which is the last step in finishing a piece of my work, is probably the most enjoyable and relaxing for me. And I know that I can go to that when I have an energy that I need to express.
Now I'm looking at the piece behind you. Is that piece from this new series?
It is. It is. It's the first layer is cotton, and then there are multiple layers of silk organza printed in a green and several figures. Mm-hmm. I call it duplicity, but the titles of my work often change depending on how I'm grouping them or where I might have the opportunity to show them.
Now, do you title your work before or after you start?
After.
Okay.
The whole process of making it and coming to a decision about how it's come together informs me about the title. I have a stack of small 5x5 images
okay.
in front of me, and I'm wondering, it's a profile silhouette, mm-hmm. and I've treated about 25 pieces of fabric with a variety of different surface design techniques, mm-hmm. and I'm going to set them in an album style setting, although they won't be pieced together. They will be hand-stitched to a base mm-hmm. fabric, and then kantha stitching, which is a Bengali running stitch, will be used to further delineate the shapes and add texture and body to the finished work.
Now, you say you really love the hand stitching part of
this. I do.
Now, mm-hmm. Are you using thicker threads, or are you using basically fine quilting techniques? What types of stuff are you using?
I use cotton embroidery floss, mm-hmm. either 2 to 4 strands, very basic. I've done a little bit of couching and would enjoy to explore that to a greater degree. This is a little harder to see. It's a shibori with the top half of the silhouette discharged with a pre-mixed formula from Dharma. I actually didn't mix it. It's very handy and easy to use around the house.
Now, Mary, we can see more of your work at your website, which is Mary T. Buchanan, which is BUCHANAN.com, correct?
That's right, Lisa. I don't do commissioned work. I am teaching some workshops and having some shows coming up soon. I'm very much looking forward to a 3-day workshop I'm teaching and a show at the Huntington Museum of Art in Huntington, West Virginia.
Ah, as well, WBA, great.
As well as a few others in my local area.
Oh, terrific. Well, we'll take a peek at your workshops in Huntington then. I'm an original West Virginian.
Oh, great.
And, yeah, half West Virginian, half New Yorker, dangerous combination.
Yeah.
So we'll take a look, and we'll put some stuff here for your website. And I thank you for interviewing with me this morning, and we look forward to coming back to seeing how this series progresses for you. So definitely keep us posted.
I appreciate your interest. Thanks so much.
Terrific. Have a terrific day.
You too.
Bye-bye.